What is architecture?
Well, the four questions you have are basically the same in another way. For me, architecture is organizing the space of our environment and in such a way that it accommodates people. And it is, in fact, and that is what can architecture do, is that it can express the cultural state of affairs in the sense that it, in different times and different circumstances, is more directed to the power or to the street, so to say, and in fact, what I think architecture should do is to guide people through the alienated and savage world, make the world for people accessible. And just accessible, not only in the physical way, but accessible in the spiritual way. It must make people feel at home, feel familiar. Whereas our world, as I said, is almost against people, with traffic, with all the dangers and things, you know. And my position as architect is mainly to domesticate the world, to provide conditions for not only for individuality, but more for social exchange. So the feeling of keeping people together so containing capacity. This is what old churches in fact did, and I'm not talking for what reason these people came together. That is something which is secondary. Primary is to make space in such a way that you feel familiar, now I'm repeating what I said already, and feel sort of togetherness, a feeling of belonging. So, without bothering about why, I mean, this could be a religious thing, it could also be a neighborhood thing. When I walk in the street in Amsterdam, near my house, I'm greeting with people I don't know, but that gives the indication that the environment is so organized that you feel, although you don't know each other, you have nothing to do with each other, you feel a sort of belonging together. My design method is slightly a different thing, in the sense that I don't try in first place to make spaces appropriate for certain tasks, but I try to to make the space appropriate for everything. No, not for everything, but for the things that in the anthropological sense stay constant, stay the same. And I want to leave all the temporary things to the people, to other people, if you like, interior architects or so, because they are temporary, they will change in time, and I want to concentrate on that which does not change, you know? The English word competence, which stands for in German Vermögen, is in fact the right example, because what you have to make is a competence that can be used in different ways by the people. I leave that to the other people. You could also say the hardware, which allows different kinds of software to complete it, you know? So I want to make the hardware. And the hardware in such a way that it accommodates people for all the things people want to do. And then always comes the question of the beauty. You never should, in my opinion, try to make something beautiful. Making things beautiful is just your handwork. You know, this is a sort of obvious thing. You try what you make, you try to make it beautiful. Although you never, I think you should not try to make something beautiful, but it's just part of your trade. No, it comes or doesn't come. What you want to make should be what is, in your opinion, necessary, and not what people generally like or not. You know? That is the position of the artistic position, in fact. What we make should be inviting, and ultimately should help human dignity.